Au sein de la grande diversité des maladies infectieuses,
within the great diversity of infectious diseases, some are very well known, HIV/AIDS, malaria, Ebola, because they're in the spotlight, but others are much less so. For some of them, the WHO has defined what could be described as a label, the neglected tropical diseases. If you look at this list, you will identify trypanosomiasis, leprosy, onchocercosis, Gurley ulcer, and you can see that they have very diverse origins. Some of them still exist, while the general public thinks that they are medieval, forgotten diseases. In January 2016, the world entered a new phase of SDGs after 15 years dedicated to MDGs, and one of the key ideas is that the fight against these neglected tropical diseases makes a major contribution to fulfilling all of the SDGs. It's, of course, connected to the Goal 3.3 about good health and well-being. But these diseases also have effects and are influenced by other fields of development covered by the SDGs. Goal 1, for instance, no poverty. Poverty in all of its forms and everywhere in the world. Programs against these neglected tropical diseases, for instance, have physical and mental consequences, which themselves affect the capacity of populations to generate income and to contribute to economic growth, as described in SDG 8. This can also be observed for others, SDG 2, for instance, zero hunger, food safety, nutrition, SDG 4, access to quality education, SDG 6, access to water, to clean water, and sanitation. SDG 11, cities, so that cities can be open to all, and be safe, resilient, and sustainable, and many others. Let me now illustrate a few interactions between SDGs or within an SDG, SDG 3 itself, for these neglected tropical diseases. And within 3 and even within 3.3, by trying to control and eradicate these diseases, there may be a negative effect on our own well-being. Everyone has heard, everyone has in mind problems of pesticides or insecticides, which then either enter our food chain or our bodies. So there's one solution in that. Case, it's to be aware of it, of measurable facts. And in order to improve and on this, we must both know the effects and anticipate them and try to favor alternative solutions. Sometimes we may need to continue to use these insecticides, in which case their use must be rationalized. Another example of interaction. Again, when eliminating or eradicating a pathogen, an insect who bears the disease. Can this have negative impacts on biodiversity?
Insects
that carry the disease are, of course, part of the overall equilibrium of the food chain. If the insect itself is eradicated, there will probably be a negative impact. It's very often difficult to measure. So the idea would be to favor, if possible, local eradication of the species.
En se contentant, entre guillemets, d'empêcher
but in fact, if you only prevent
puisqu'on veut le protéger, donc
the transfer to humans
ou du vecteur qui
of the pathogen,
on peut à la fois protéger
or of the vector that carries the pathogen, you can both protect humans
et
and have a very limited and acceptable impact on the rest of the environmental chain, the balances of the ecosystem.
Dans un cas un peu concret.
Another example, perhaps a more concrete example, the tsetse fly
en fait, elle
transmits a disease,
qui
a parasite,
à la fois
the trypanosoma, which creates diseases that is known as the sleeping disease, and also to livestock. Let's take an area in Africa where the animal disease transmitted by the tsetse fly exists. Of course, we try to act to prevent the cattle from becoming infected in order to improve food safety and the incomes of the farmers. There are several types of bovines. There are some that are trypanotolerant. They probably have developed a tolerance to infection by being smaller and lighter animals. There are also zebus in that zone that came to Africa more recently. They have a hump and they're slightly more sensitive to the disease. They resist less well. They are bigger. So if we eliminate the tsetse fly,
en fait, les éleveurs vont se tourner vers l'importation de races européennes, comme ces belles charolaises que vous voyez là, qui évidemment produisent beaucoup plus de viande.
Ranchers will probably be importing Western varieties of cows, which produce much more meat and much more milk, which will probably be subjected to much more severe problems if they're imported. Not to mention the fact that we will also have eliminated the local genetic resources. So the solution in this case is to try to keep all of this in mind and when implementing these programs to try and think about valuing local genetic resources. And that is a fine illustration of the interaction between the various SDGs. If we look at infectious disease and climate change, between SDG 3 and SDG 13, some say that with climate change, there will be a multiplication of vectors and a great number of epidemics. But that won't always be the case. There are also instances where, on the contrary, one would need to have the ability to leverage these conditions which are imposed upon us of gentrification and global climate change, a deterioration of habitats and conditions that are unfavorable for these insects, these disease-carrying insects. So you need to seize upon the opportunity that now exists and that did not exist before to put an end to the threat they represent. So this can balance what we hear about. And the interaction is not only one way. It can also be leveraged positively to fight against these diseases. So if you ask me why eliminate these infectious diseases, and particularly these neglected tropical diseases, I will tell you in a simple and basic form. Simple, because it's a human right, Article 25 of the Universal Declaration of Human Rights, 1948. Any person has the right to sufficient living standards to ensure their health, well-being, and that of their family. Basic, it's of course a contribution to the SDGs, but not only. The scientists and experts are saying that for these diseases, at least some of these diseases, it's feasible, simple. That's what we would do if it was our own country, and it's what we have done, because we have eradicated malaria, which no longer exists in France. Basic. avoiding these diseases where prevalences are dropped, returning. Think of trypanosomiasis, I mean, Zika virus, Ebola virus. Simple, because if you eliminate them where they are most active, which is often far away, you avoid any risk of importing them into our own countries. I hope I've managed to convince you. Let's work together. Thanks.
Voilà, j'espère vous avoir convaincu. Faisons-le tous ensemble. Merci.